Hello everyone, today I'll tell you about such an element as neon. Neon is a noble gas that is located in the 8th group of the periodic table of chemical elements. Below helium, this gas is called noble because of the fact that it practically doesn't react with any substances, which means it does not give or attach electrons. Neon is a colorless gas with no taste or smell, the content of which in the atmosphere is 126 ppm percent by mass. Since neon has no chemical compounds, let's talk about its physical properties. By passing high voltage through the gas, it begins to glow with a red-orange light. The luminescence intensity will depend on the voltage and the gas pressure. The gas pressure in this vial is about 1/100 of the atmospheric pressure. This is done in order to reduce the voltage required for the elimination of the gas in discharge current. I'm not good in physics, but I will try to explain the mechanism of the luminescence of neon in simple words. As a high voltage source, I used an old plasma lamp, which has a generator of high voltage, high frequency and low amperage. At high voltage, electrons are seeking to fly out from the electrode, i.e. the cathode. When being approached by a neon vial, electrons fly out of the metal wire. Part of them passes through the glass and begins to encounter molecules of neon inside the vial. The neon atoms are excited by the collision with electrons in the same way as a man who has pushed in a roadway in a crowd. The electrons in the atom of neon are not inclined to wander around. Therefore, after the excitation, the atom relaxes and the electron goes back to its place. As a result, the atom emits a photon of light. The energy of the photons lies in the red part of the spectrum of visible light. My hand here plays the role of capacitor because of the current for the lighting of the neon in the lamp. Because the current for the lighting of the neon in the lamp is extremely small. Based on this property is how many of the neon signs work, which are, by the way, filled not only with neon but also with other gases as well. The properties of the neon to emit light under the influence of electricity is used in Nixie tubes, like in these retro clocks, based on the Soviet indicators. The pressure of gas in these lamps is a few millimeters of mercury, and the current passing through the digits is about 100 volts. Due to the fact that the voltage is not very large, only a thin layer of gas near the digits glows, and not the whole lamp. This effect is called the glow discharge. The light emanates from the negatively charged electrode, the cathode. The color of the glow depends on the gas type. On a glow discharge, the gas conducts electricity well, which therefore means a strong ionization is always constantly support within the gas. In these discharge lamps, a bit of mercury is added to the neon to facilitate an easier ignition of the gas and to increase the overall lifespan. By the way, those who feel they have grown some attraction to this type of clock since the video started, you can buy them with the link I put in the description. In the dark you can spot that around the yellow digits there is a bluish halo caused by the mercury vapor contained in the lamp. Mercury emits ultraviolet light when electric current passes through its vapor. I hope this video was informative and useful. If you want more interesting videos, subscribe to my channel and add some likes. Those who like the retro clocks, don't forget to check the description of the video.